Peggy 18.
Hey everybody, Carl from Crystal Dynamics. So hopefully by now you've had a chance to see our first trailer from this new game Tomb Raider entitled Turning Point. If not, before we go any further, take a chance to go and have a look. Visit TombRaider.com or YouTube.com/Tomb Raider. So this is a massive project for us here at Crystal Dynamics. Not only is it the first trailer of the campaign, sort of setting the tone and ambition for our vision, but it's also the first time that we had a chance to work with some of our acclaimed partners, including Visual Works, based out of Tokyo. Over the next few minutes, you're going to get a behind-the-scenes look at how we took concept all the way through to our global launch pre-E3 this year. Hear from some of the people who were integral to the process, including Ikemori-san and Zoe-san from the acclaimed Visual Works studio. So without further ado, let's dip in and give you a behind-the-scenes look at this acclaimed Tomb Raider Turning Point making of.
Before we get into the trailer itself, it's important to put that in the context of the larger story that we wanted to tell. This is Lara's first big adventure. She's fresh out of college, but her life's passion that Lara wants more than anything to establish herself as an explorer, as an adventurer, as an archaeologist. In picking a destination for Lara's adventure, we really wanted to make sure that she was put through an ordeal that would transform her from this young, ambitious archaeologist into the Tomb Raider that she would become.
She really goes through a massive arc. This is a Lara in a situation that we've never seen before. So the goal was that by the time you get to the end of the trailer, you really feel like she's about to embark on something very new and very different, and she doesn't really know whether or not this is her. So when we began the process of looking for a partner to be able to create this trailer, we looked at tons of people. We've worked with many people in the industry over the years, from LA to the UK. And really, what came to a head was the Deus Ex trailer. Visual Works had just begun working with Montreal and created, probably to us, was the most mind-blowing CG we've ever seen in our lives.
Visual Works is 内部
So the partnership began last year at E3. That was our first time really meeting with them. So Visual Works for many, many years now been worked on a lot of the Final Fantasy trailers. And as we all know, over the years they've gotten better and better and better, and the detail and the attention has become absolutely phenomenal. And for us, it was trying to bring a piece of that to our trailer.
どういうところが違うかと言われるとなかなか、まあリアルだけを追求してるわけではなく、そこにやはりアートの部分をかなり入れて、意外とリアルリズムの中に実はデフォルメが非常に入っているっていう世界観が非常に使いこなしていると。要は、ただ単にリアルに持っていく先をゴールにせずに、その先に我々はやっぱり勝負をかけているっていうところがあります。
So not too long after E3 was finished, Ikemori-san and Zoe-san took the trip out to the studio. We had a chance to show them not only the game, but to also sit down and pitch some of the ideas that we had.
一番はやっぱりその、一回このお仕事をいただく前に、クリスタルダイナミクスさんの方に遊びに行ったんですけれども、遊びというか見学に行ったんですけれども、その時にやっぱり皆さん本当に必死に 一生懸命仕事をされてるんですよ。もうすごい楽しんでやらせて、で、それに一番刺激を受けて、受けたというか、その刺激が、一番大きかったものというか。We
had done research on a couple different partners, and Visual Works was by far the best partner we could work with. The work they had done on Deus Ex was amazing, and we wanted to try to harness that for Tomb Raider.
コンセプトアートをクリスタルダイナミクスで見せてもらった時のララが非常に、なんていうのかな、
My
role in that project was to sort of consult and try to make sure that the Lara we brought to the screen was going to be consistent with the game vision. Our number one goal was to make sure we brought an emotional Lara to the screen. Not only did she have to look beautiful, you know, but she had to really convey a complex emotion. And because she's going through some extreme circumstances, to see that fear.
本当に普通の女の子のLaraがどういうふうに成長していくのかっていう話になると思うんですけども、普通の人が、そういう状況下に置かれてどういうふうな恐怖感を抱くのかとか、どういうふうにその問題を解決していこうかっていうところを結構真剣に考えたというか。
So our main focus was how do we make sure she looks consistent, you know, she looks like we conceptualized, but also conveying these extreme emotions and to really tell that story.
制作フローがあるんですけど、その例えばレイアウトかアニマティクスから始まってアニメーションで、クロスシミュレーションエフェクトレンダリングっていうようなフローがあるんですけども、そこのやっぱりフローっていうのがなかなか他の方には理解しがたい部分なんで、そういう意味で例えばその今まだこのアニマティクスのフェーズの状態であるのっていうのがなかなかやっぱり伝わらなくて、そのアニメーションが早く見たいとかいつできるんだっていう話とかはありました。僕らもやっぱり一回プロジェクトを終えると次にまた新しいことに挑戦したくなっちゃうんで、水の表現ずっと昔からやってるんですけど、どんどんどんどんこうしたああしたいっていうのが積もってきてるんですよ。それをやっぱりこのトレーラーの制作期間の中で全部やろうとしてるんで、そこが結構大変だったりとか。
Visual Works sent us their first take on Lara. It was literally right out of the box. We gave them concept art, we gave them our model, you know, and we were blown away. I mean, they really brought Lara to the next level.Visual Works has this amazing simulation system. I mean, they're able to bring these characters to life, but also all the fabrics, the weather, everything you saw on there was very difficult to do. From the way the wind took the clothes, and you see it billowing through when she's underwater, you can see the water actually displaces the fabrics around, and the hair, and the way everything moved. We had to not only render hair, you know,In a dry situation, but we had to make sure it looked good wet, we had to make sure it looked good dirty. All of those things were different degrees of simulation that Visual Works just did an amazing job bringing to bear.
Ikomori-san is a real taskmaster when it comes to detail. When we look at the model that was delivered to us, it blew our mind from day one. And I think when I look at it, I think the painstaking hours that we've put in with making sure that we show a side to a character that we have never shown before. So one of the biggest pillars throughout our game, which we wanted to make sure we transferred across into the trailer, is audio.
So the most important part for us for audio was really to bring the world to life. And really make you feel as though this could be a real place. One of the sounds that we created was the sound of Lara's cabin. The sound is typical of the kind of detail that we go into, and it's probably something that you'd never even notice.
I walked out of my office one day and around into the kitchen, and there was a guy on his hands and knees with a microphone jammed into a vending machine with his hand contorted over the back, trying to get this dull hum. When I asked him what he was doing, he was like, "This is Lara's cabin." And we played it back, amazingly enough, with a little bit of tweaking, it sounds exactly as you would imagine the inside of a cabin on a ship to be.
So for the scene where Lara's on the beach, our composer wrote a piece that was very intimate and extremely important in terms of the story and the arc of the trailer. We really wanted to get the most out of this scene, and it just so happened we have a concert violinist on staff. So we got him to come into the studio, and the composer was able to direct him over Skype and get the perfect performance for that scene.
So one of the key things with this trailer from day one is that I wanted to try and achieve a quality which we haven't had in any of our trailers before.
We've all worked on many, many gameplay trailers. We've had some of the spikes and the highs and lows of introducing characters and feature sets, but this had something more, had some more detail, which we knew from day one was going to be much harder to try and communicate. We began working with Ignition, a studio who I'm very fond of, and I've loved their work over the last few years. They've done some tremendous movies and some tremendous trailers. I think trailers such as the ones from Inception were ones that kind of blew me away. The team down there really embraced our vision. They really embraced the goals that we had to be able to sort of show Lara in a very different light. Even the trailer that came back from Visual Works, being that it was 4 minutes long probably at the time, when we started eating into it with Ignition, we cut it all the way down to about 3 minutes that you see today.
First up, the return of Lara Croft in a completely reimagined Tomb Raider. In this game, you'll meet a young 21-year-old Lara as she washes ashore off the coast of Japan after a fierce storm destroys the ship Endurance. There's going to be a lot of talk about this game at E3 next week, but right now we've got the exclusive world premiere of the cinematic trailer for Tomb Raider.
So just before E3, we had the opportunity to air it on the Spike GTTV pre-E3 show. And it really was exciting. For months, we'd spent so much time gearing up to this date. I've been working with Jeff to try and get prime position, and it was great. He gave us the first trailer of the entire show. And the minute it aired, it went global. We've had millions and millions of views. We're really delighted by the success of it. And obviously, the comments and feedback that we've had from fans and from just gamers around the world.
So there you have it. Behind the scenes look at how we made the Tomb Raider Turning Point trailer. So a big thank you to all the people involved, from Visual Works in Tokyo, to the team here behind the scenes at Crystal Dynamics, and the team in Ignition down in LA. We hope you enjoyed looking at this trailer. We hope to bring you more throughout the entire campaign. Thank you very much and goodbye.